Hey there, friends. Welcome back to Beloved Plans. This is Amy, and today I'm going to be showing you guys how I get my budget mom printable workbook pages to fit into my classic sized budgeting happy planner. If you're new to my channel, this is Beloved Plans, and my name is Amy, and this channel is for anyone who is looking to get more organized in their finances, productivity, business, and day-to-day life. So let's get started. So in order to get to this point, there's a few really important steps that you guys have to take. So let's pop over to my computer screen and I will show you how I got these to print two-sided and at the right percentage to fit into the classic sized happy planner.
Print is we're gonna go to the PDF files of the Budget by Paycheck workbook. I have both the old workbook and the new workbook highlighted here in purple. So you wanna make sure that you're using the version that says for bookbinding if you're using the old version, or back to back if you're using the 2020 version. The reason being that these files have the proper margin set up so that when you go to print them and you print them resized down and back to back, the margins will line up correctly to be able to be bound on the one side. So we're gonna go ahead and open up the back to back one. And here it is. I'm using Adobe Reader. As you can see down here, you can also use the preview software that comes on the Mac as well. Either one will work. So we're gonna go to the pages that we want to print. So I'm going today gonna be printing some extra Budget by Paycheck pages for January. So you navigate over here on the side, or you can scroll down here too. Either way, whatever's easiest, and you get to the pages you wanna print. I like to use this little thumbnail sidebar over here. Makes it really easy to select the pages I'm wanting to print. So I'm gonna go to January and find my Budget by Paycheck pages I want. Okay, here we go. And then I have it set up right now, so I'm viewing them like as they would be open. So I'm viewing two pages at a time. So I'm gonna do front and back for both of those. So I'm gonna highlight, I need two sets. So I'm gonna highlight pages 28 through 31 over here in the sidebar on the left. And then I am going to go to print them. So in this dialog box is where you will change it down to be custom scale. And I'm gonna put 84%. When I tab out of that, then it resizes it in the preview over here on the right and shows me. Then I'm going to click print on both sides of paper. And for this, if this gives you an option in the software you're using, you want to be sure that you select flip on long edge so that it is flipped correctly when it does the two-sided printing. And then we just hit print.
Okay, so now that we have printed these off at 84% using the back-to-back version of the workbook, now we're gonna trim them down so that they fit into the classic sized happy planner. So I have them printed. This right now I'm gonna be doing February 2021. So I am going to trim them down. So I'll get out my paper trimmer. I will link to this paper trimmer down in the description below. It comes with replaceable little blades as well. So I'll link to those. But I just went ahead when I first got this trimmer and I used some washi tape to just mark out the spots where I needed to make my first cuts. So the final page size we're going to get down to is 7 inches by 9.25 inches, or 9 1/4 inches. There is a little bit of wiggle room on these. So if you want it to go a little bit bigger, you certainly can. If you're laminating something though, I wouldn't go any bigger than that. But sometimes I will leave a little bit of extra space, especially where on the side I'm gonna punch on. So I just usually grab like 3 pages at a time and I put them in here, and I'm gonna make my first cut at about 7 3/4 inches here. Line that up, trim it, and then I just rotate it and I make my next cut, which is at 10 1/4 inches. And then I do the same thing here, except now I'm gonna line it up with the 7. And if that seems like it's gonna be a little too close to the edge, I will sometimes just pull it over just a smidge so I have a little bit more margin there. So see how that comes out with a nice little margin. My punches are gonna go on this side. So then I'm gonna make my last cut, which is gonna be at usually around, I usually do it a little bit longer than 9 1/4, right around there. All right, and then we have them cut down. So I'm gonna finish doing that with these pages, and then we'll pop back on here and show you guys how we punch them. So now we have all of these punched and I have them lined up so that the area I'm gonna punch is all over. This one is blank because I'm actually gonna adhere it to the calendar of my planner page. But then in here, they are all two-sided with the paycheck bill checkers. And then it goes into, you know, my expense trackers, etc. So got them all ready to go and I have them all lined up so that the margin where I'm gonna punch is on the same side. So we'll put away the punch, or I'm sorry, the trimmer. And I use a couple different trimmers. I use the Arc Punch from Staples, which I will link below. I do really love that one because you can do like at least 5 or 6 pages at a time. Whereas this Happy Planner one, you can only do a maximum of 3 pages at a time. So I am gonna use this one just because I do like how the punches are exactly the same as what's already in my Happy Planner, because the Arc one is a tiny bit shorter and it does annoy me just a little bit. So that's why I did get this punch. So I'm gonna go ahead and 3 pages at a time, I will get this punch. So now I'm just going to go ahead and flip to my February tab in my budget planner, and I'm going to pop them in. And so as you can see, they fit perfectly in here. They look great. So when it's time for me to move my February into my catch-all planner, I will pull these pages out and put them in my catch-all planner. So I hope you guys found this helpful. Please be sure to ask any questions down in the comments below. If you enjoyed this video, I would love for you to give it a thumbs up. If you're new here, I would love to have you subscribe so you never miss a future video. You can also click the little bell so that you're notified every time I post a new video. If you'd like to see how I have my 2021 budget planner set up, I'm going to go ahead and link to that video right now over on the right side, and you guys can check out how I have my whole planner set up for 2021 for my budgeting. So I'll see you over there.